Now let's look at lengths and areas of plane geometric figures. So what do we mean by when we say a plane figure? A plane figure is a figure that lies in the two-dimensional plane, meaning that it has no depth or thickness. So as you can see, these are all examples of plane figures. So you have your triangles, then you have your circle, then you have your quadrilaterals, which are made up of square, rectangle, rhombus, rhomboid, trapezium, and trapezium. And we also have our polygons, as you can see. So any shape or figure that is made up of just the length and the breadth, in which there is no depth or height or thickness, we refer to it as a plane figure. So the first property of plane figure we're going to talk about is the perimeter. So what is the perimeter? The perimeter is the distance around the edge of the shape. So if I have a shape, for example, let's look at this square, in which I have four sides. So this is the boundary or the edges of the square. So the length of all those edges is what we refer to as the perimeter. So as you know, let's assume that one of the length here is S. So since this is square, all the sides are equal, so other sides will be invariably S. So the perimeter will just be the sum of all those sides. So you have S plus S plus S plus S, and that is equals to 4S. So the perimeter of a square is 4 times one of the lengths. If you have a rectangle as shown here, you can see that the opposite sides are equal. So AA and here is B and here is B. So the perimeter will just be the sum of all the lengths. So that will be A plus A plus B plus B. A plus A gives me 2A, and B plus B gives me 2B. If I factor out the 2, I have 2 into bracket A plus B. So what about a triangle? So for the perimeter of a triangle, you just have the sum of the length of the side. So if length of this side is A, length of here is B, and the length of here is C, the perimeter is just the sum of the length of the sides. And for a circle, the perimeter is given as what? As 2 pi r. So the circumference of the circle is given as well, 2 pi r, where r is the radius. And if you recall, the radius is what? Half of the diameter. So if I substitute here, I have circumference equals to 2, instead of having 2 pi r, if I replace r with the diameter over 2, I have 2 pi d over 2, and 2 cancels 2. So the circumference is also given as what? Pi d. So either you have pi times the diameter or you have 2 pi r, they both mean the same thing. We have is the radius and this is the diameter of the circle. Let's quickly look at one example. So here we have an irregular shape now. I'm told to find the missing sides and the perimeter of this plane figure. So we know that the perimeter will be the sum of all the edges that this plane figure has, but we don't know the length of this side over here, and we don't know the length of this side over here. But we know that the length from here to here is given as what? 3. And the length from here to here is 5. So we know that the length from here to here will just be the sum of those two shorter lengths, which will be 3 plus 5. So the length of this side over here is what? 8. Now for this side over here that we don't know, see that the length from here to here is 10. And the length from here to here is 4. So what will be the length of this remaining section here? So the length over here will just be what? 10 minus 4. And that is equal to 6. So the length over here is 6. So the perimeter will just be the sum of all the lengths of the side. So the perimeter will be 4. This 4 plus 3 plus 6 plus 5 plus 10 and plus 8 plus 5 plus 10 and plus 8. That goes to 36 centimeters. So that really sums up the discussion on perimeter, and I'm not going to delve too deep because I believe that by now you know how to calculate perimeters of simple shape, because you should be familiar with that. So let's move on to areas. So areas just calculate the amount of space inside the boundary of a plane figure. So in this case now, I have a triangle. So if I'm trying to measure what space is within this triangle, that quantity is referred to as the area. So the area just measures the space within the boundary of a plane figure. So the area of a triangle is given as half times base times height. The area of a rectangle is given by the width, the length times the breadth. then the area of a trapezoid is given by half of the sum of the two opposite and parallel sides, then times the vertical height. Area of a square is given as the length squared. Area of parallelogram is given by base times height, and the area of a circle is pi r squared. And I believe that by now you should be familiar with these formulas also, and if you are not, you should try to memorize them. So let's look at some examples. And here we are told to find the area of the plane figures below. We are told that all measurements are in centimeters. So here we have a triangle. So know that the area of a triangle is given as what? Half times base times height. And now what is the base? You know that our base is 12 centimeters and our height is 4 centimeters. So our area will just be half times 12 times 4. So 2 here goes here and 2 here goes here too. And what would that be? That would be 24 centimeters squared. So the area of this triangle is 24 centimeters squared. Now let's look at this parallelogram over here. I was told to find the area. We know that the area of a parallelogram is given as the base times the height. Now we know that the base is 7, and why the vertical height? Remember, for the height, we are referring to the vertical height and not the slant length, slant height. So the vertical height. So the vertical height here is 4. So the area will just be 7 times 4. And what does that give us? 28 centimeter squared. So let's look at another example. We are told to find the perimeter and area of a circle with radius 14 centimeter. So we have a circle. And we are told that the radius of the circle is 14 centimeter. So first, we are told to calculate the perimeter. So we know that the perimeter of a circle is given as 2 pi r. And for this case, I'm going to say we should take pi as being equal to 22 over 7. Pi can be 22 over 7 or 3.1412, but let's use this value for now. So our perimeter will be 2 times, and what is my pi? 22 over 7, and what is my radius? 14. 7 here, 1, 7 here goes to 2 times 22 times 2 gives me 88 centimeters squared. And so 88 centimeter. Yeah, you have to take note. The unit of perimeter is in length, so you just have just maybe centimeter. Why the units of areas is in cm squared or unit squared. So now let's calculate the area. We know that the area of a circle is given as pi r squared, and we know that our pi now is 22 over 7, and our radius is 14 squared. 14 squared is same thing as 14 times 14, so that would be 22 times 14 times 14, then here over 7. And when you do this, here goes to, so 22 times 2 times 14 gives us what? 616 centimeter squared. So that represents the area. Now on to the next example. Here we are told to find the perimeter and the area of the figure below. To find the perimeter, first we know that the perimeter is the sum of all the length. So the sum of this length over here, AD, plus the sum of BC plus the sum of CB plus the sum of AB will give me the perimeter. Now I know AB is 20, BC is 13, DC is 25, but I don't know AD. So to find AD, I know that AD, since here is perpendicular or is vertical, and this also is vertical, I know that AD, length AD or line AD is equals to line BP, the length of line BP over here. So now I can calculate this. So now I have this triangle over here, and I'm told that from here to here is 20. So I know that from here to here is also 20. And if I'm told that the total length of DC is 25, I know that the length of PC must be what? Must be 5. So this section here is 20, while the smaller section here is 5. So if I bring out this right angle triangle, I have something like this, in which you have 13 here and you have 5 here. And now I'm trying to find the height, and let me call it H, like we've talked before. So now I know that from Pythagoras' theorem. So if you don't know our Pythagoras theorem, you should check out the section on trigonometry. So now we know that from Pythagoras theorem that h squared will be equal to the hypotenuse squared, 13 squared minus 5 squared. So what would that be? H squared will be equal to 169 minus 25, which is equal to what? 144. So to remove the square, I just find the square root of both sides, and when I do that, find that the value of h is 12. So here is 12, so that means the length here is what, 12, and that means also that the length here will also be what, 12. So I can find my perimeter now. So my perimeter is just the sum of the sides. So my perimeter now will just be equals to what, this length AB here, 20, plus this length AJ, which is what, 13, plus this total length here, which is 25, and plus this length over here, which is 12. And what does that give us? That gives us 70 centimeters. So now the second part asks us to find the area. And we know that this is a trapezoid. And we know that the area is given as what? Half into brackets A plus B times the height. So what do we have? We know that our A now is this length over here, which is 20, and our B is what? 25, and our vertical height is 12. So we have half into brackets 20 plus 25 times 12. And what does that give us? That gives us half times 45 times 12. 2 year 1, 2 year 6, and 45 times 6 gives us 270. And remember, the unit now will be centimeter square. So the units of perimeter in length, meter or centimeter, why the units of area are in length squared? So either centimeter squared or meter squared, depending on the unit. Let's look at another example, and this will be the last example that we'll look at in this section. So you are told to calculate the area of this figure. So as you can see, you have a composite figure in which you have a semicircle on top over here. Semicircle is half of a circle, and at the bottom part you have what? You have a trapezium. So let's draw that out. So let's start out with the semicircle. So you have a semicircle like this. So to find the area, we just need to find the area of this smaller component, composite figures, and sum them together. So for this semicircle, we're told that the diameter is 20. So what will be the radius? The radius is the diameter over 2. And that is 20 over 2. So the radius is what? 10 millimeter. So the radius here is what? 10 millimeter. So now to find the area of a semicircle, we just need to find the area of a full circle and divide it by 2. Because you know that a semicircle is half of a circle. So the area of a circle is what? Pi r squared. So since you're having a semicircle, now we have to divide our result by 2. So the area will just be what? Pi times, and what is our radius here? 10 squared over 5. And for this example, let's take our value of pi to be equal to 3.142. So now what do we have? We have what? 3.142 times 100 over, and this is a mistake, this is supposed to be a 2 and not a 5 under here. So we have what? So we have a 2 over here, and this becomes, so when we work on this, what do we have? We have 157.1 centimeter squared. So we are done with the semicircle section. Now let's move on to the trapezoid section, and we have something like this. So we are told that the height here is 14 millimeter. I'm sorry, there's a mistake. The unit here will be millimeter squared and not centimeters. So we are told that here is 14, and here is 32, and here is 20. So we can find the area. We know that the area of trapezoid is given as half into bracket A plus B times the vertical height. So that will be what? Half into bracket, the value of A is 20, value of B, this length over here, is 32, and my vertical height is 14. So 2 year, 1 year, and 2 year gives me 7. So I'm left with what? 52 times 7. How does that give me? 364 millimeter squared. So, but the question asks us to find the area of the figure. So the total area now will just be the sum of those two composite, the area of those two composite figures. So which will be what? 157.1 plus 364. And what would that result in? That would result in 521.1 millimeter squared. So that is the total area of this figure. So to recap, what we did was that we divided this figure into fractions or composites in which we knew the formula to calculate the area. So we ended up with a semicircle, and we ended up with a parallelogram. So for the semicircle, We just found the area of the circle and we divided it by 2. So we have power squared as the area of the circle divided by 2 to give us the area of a semicircle. And when we've gotten that, then we moved on to the trapezium. And we used the formula of trapezium to calculate the area over here. And we got it to be 364 millimeter squared. And what we finally did to get the total area was to sum the area of those two composite figures, or those two smaller fractions. And what we got was 521.1 millimeter squared. So this pretty much sums up our discussion on perimeters and areas of plane figures.